Today's Julia talks to yesterday's Julia, and we get to listen in on Smart Money. Welcome to Smart Money. I'm Pat Boyle, along with my co-host. We'll call her Today's Julia because that's the theme, yeah. Today and Yesterday's Julia. Welcome in. We want to start the show with Julia with a really sobering and stunning fact. 40% of women, only 47%, are confident talking about money and investments with a professional. This is according to Fidelity Investments. And that is why I'm glad that we have you here, one of these women who is confident talking about money. We're going to time travel a little bit, if you don't mind. If you could go back, you, Julia, today, could go back and talk to Julia of yesteryear and give yourself, your younger self, a pep talk about investing and money, where would you start?
I would start with investing early, something
that I really didn't get around to doing until my early 40s. If I had to do it again, it would be in my 20s. I would have my own little IRA, and I would be putting money in it on a regular basis. I'm not worrying about the stock market going up or down, but I would start investing much earlier, and I would be much better off today if I had.
Well, this isn't a pop quiz, but we have 11 things that you think young Julia should have known then that today's Julia knows now. So let's start with number one. Invest early and stick with it?
Right, that would be it.
Okay, what about management fees?
That's the other thing that I knew nothing about. And these are, by the way, mostly mistakes I made. Management fees in whatever funds you're investing in inside of your employment fund, like 401k or another like that, a deferred tax accounts. I would really want to know what the investment fees were for those funds, because they really make a difference over the long term. In other words, if you have an investment fee of 1.5, a management fee of 1.5 versus one that's 0.5%, makes a huge difference on the outcome, hundreds of thousands of dollars difference. And then I would also be looking at fees for if you have an advisor, a financial advisor, mm-hmm. Be sure you're asking them how they're making their money. You know, how much are they charging for that?
Your third advice to yesteryear Julia is avoid debt. Sounds so simple.
Oh yes, it's really simple. You know, maybe mortgage debt is something that you have to take on if you're going to buy a house, which you just need to be negotiating the best interest rate for. But in terms of car loans and credit card debt, that's not so good, because you're chucking a lot of interest money down the drain because you're having to pay a fee on those loans. And if you are borrowing, say, to buy a car, be sure you're reading the fine print on that stuff. One of my experiences was buying a car. I thought I was getting a 3-year loan. Mm-hmm. I got home, read the fine print. It was a 4-year loan.
No fair.
No.
No. Young Julia.
I know.
I'm glad we have today's Julia. Another thing is, when bad things happen to good people, such as yourself.
Well, bad things can happen. And sometimes women find themselves on their own financially. Divorce.
Yep.
There's a lot of divorces out there in the world. And you need to be thinking about, what's the worst case scenario? What could go wrong here? And how financially would I manage that? Death of a spouse. I have a couple of my friends who were in their early 60s lost their spouses, and one of them was pretty well prepared financially and the other one wasn't. And you really need to know what it would be like to be financially on your own.
So it's a nest egg or emergency fund, rainy day fund. Just have a fund, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Right.
Also have a will. When? How early?
Well, I didn't get around to having a will. I don't know about you, but I didn't think about it until I was in my 40s, and I finally wrote a will. And if I'd done it sooner, I would probably have been doing everybody a favor, especially my kids. If, you know, I died in some kind of car accident or something, there would have been instructions on how my kids would have been taken care of. So there's reasons why younger women need to have a will, not just, you know, when you're getting into your later golden years. So a will, I think, is really important for everybody.
And it is hard. We did our first will, a boilerplate, when we were in our 30s. We were doing an overseas trip. The kids stayed at home. And really, it was just like, well, who should take the kids?
Right.
I don't know. How about, you know, Aunt Leanne, or how about Aunt Pei? I mean, that was the extent
exactly.
of our will thinking. So,
well, better than nothing.
Slightly.
Something like only half of Americans have a will, even now.
That's kind of scary.
It is. They need one.
Another tip to young Julia, do not be a shrinking violet when it comes to salary.
Right. Ask for pay raises. My personal experience was another woman and I working in our newsroom found out we were making several tens of thousands of dollars less than the men in the same jobs. Mm. It wasn't really something the company had deliberately done, but it just sort of happened. So we were able to negotiate some substantial pay increases because we discovered that disparity in pay. And in general, I think people maybe these days are more comfortable with asking for pay raises, but it's definitely part of the plan, and you shouldn't be embarrassed or shy about it.
Well, especially in this job market, I think a lot of people are asking for them. Also, you say learn about investing. So with an advisor, just take a leap by yourself, or how does one do that?
Well, you know, I had the good fortune of having a mother who thought investing was fun and not very hard to do. So I got to learn a little bit from her. But for a lot of women, that's not the case. And I think all women need to be financially literate. They need to know about the stock market. They need to know how to invest their money inside of a 401k. They may be worried about, you know, ups and downs of the market, and they put it in a money market fund. That's not going to do you any good because you're actually losing money on inflation. And so women need to understand the basics of the economy and investing. And however you go about doing that is up to you. But, you know, maybe you need a financial advisor who's going to give you those basics.
Social Security, understand it. How hard is that to understand Social Security? A lot of fine print there.
Well, see, this was a big one for me because I didn't really pay a lot of attention to Social Security. I knew that when I got to 62, I could claim benefits. But there are so many variations on how and when to claim Social Security benefits. One of the basics is the longer you wait, the bigger the benefit will be. And then there's ex-spouses that you can claim on without causing any trouble, really, mm-hmm. with them. There's just a whole lot of things to think about. So if I had to do it again, I would be looking into all those combinations and variables.
And what I have found is that there are arguments both ways. Like, well, they say wait, no, they say it doesn't matter. And so it's like almost like a ping pong table, like which one do I go with?
I would go in and make an appointment with a Social Security representative somewhere in your area. And mm-hmm. they have local offices, and they will give you the straight scoop. They will look at all your options, and they will tell you, well, we think this might be the better way for you to go.
And I know when I retired, I looked at Social Security. I was doing it a few months earlier than I had intended. I thought, nah, it's just a couple bucks. I'm going. So that was my, it helped to track the figures and just know
yeah.
dollars and cents what that would be. Also, Julia, today's Julia says to young Julia, please learn the difference between saving and investing.
Yes. Saving is one thing, investing is another. Saving is putting money into a money market fund or a bank savings account, that sort of thing. Investing is actually making that money work for you.
Right.
And so you need an emergency fund. That's the first thing. But then you need to be saving for the long term, for your old age, with or without a spouse. And to do that well, you need to invest in the American stock market. It's ruled by law, mostly. Mm-hmm. There are dividends to reinvest over time, and investing is something that every woman needs to know how to do, or at least the basics of how to do it.
I skipped over this one earlier, but I'm going back to it now because I just love the way it sounds. Do not sneer at money, young Julia, old Julia, today's
well,
Julia.
I think a lot of women do sneer at money. You know, we were raised to be good-hearted, caring people who put other people first. You know, you care about your children, your family. Money is not that important. You know, you don't want to feel like you're looking greedy or that money is everything. That's just kind of against a lot of things that especially women are, you know, are kind of trained to think about. So you don't need to sneer at money. You need to pay attention to it. And you need to decide, you know, okay, the long term, how much am I going to have when I retire? And is that going to prevent me from, you know, enjoying life? And so you can't sneer at it. You just have to deal with it.
Any other last thoughts for yesterday's Julia before we go?
Enjoy life. You know, life unfolds before you as you go through various stages working. I worked for 30 years flat out, and I enjoyed the work. Doesn't mean that work will end even though you retire from the big job. There's still ways to work part-time, which I think a lot of women do in their 60s, maybe into their 70s. So I would just look at every opportunity as something to enjoy and benefit from.
That's awesome. And people can get more financial support and help in the new edition of your book, which is so awesome. First came out in 2018, Smart Women, Smart Money, Smart Life. And it's a great read. I suggest it to everybody.
It's now a new version, updated chapters, the 2022 version.
I love it.
Well, Pat, I want to thank you for letting me talk to my younger self.
I'm glad you two got to meet again.
I know. And as I said earlier, you know, most of these tips I have are all about the mistakes I made as I went through various phases. So I really appreciate you letting me at least air all this.
No, it's great. And both Julias want you to know that you can get more financial support from her book, the new edition of Smart Women, Smart Money, Smart Life. It's a great read.
For more information, go to my website at 60andsingle.com.